great. It's going to be really helpful.
Talking about all this innovation that's going to happen,
But we, the main concern first needs to be bringing up these students, because they've seen that they're already doing lower than the students that are already in Edgecombe County. So they wanna make sure that that's the first thing that happens before we start talking about innovation, before we start talking about, you know, what it's going to look like. We wanna make sure that our concern is on that. What they just said so far is that this money that's been going over there hasn't really affected our actual Edgecombe County students.
Yeah, thank you.
So if I could have your attention, we're at the end of the night. And so I just wanna address just a few things. First of all, I wanna just bring your attention to the survey. So Mr. Cannon mentioned the survey. You can take a picture of it. I don't know if there are any other methods in which.
Yeah, there are surveys on the table. There are flyers. Please don't use the barcode on that. Use the link. Use the link that's next to the barcode. And that'll take you to the survey.
Okay.
Please map those off into the issue.
So before you start looking to the survey, if you want to give me your attention, I want to say thank you. Thank you for taking time out of your very busy schedule, because I know we all have things to do. We were supposed to end at 6:30, we're a little bit over that time. I want to thank our elected officials. I want to thank media folks who came to kind of capture this and help us with this. I want to thank you all again for again caring enough to hear, to engage, and to share your thoughts and be honest. I do want to push back on one thing. I heard at the table with Dr. Meyer that our students, maybe in Nash, are lower or not performing well. And so before we do innovation, we want to make sure that we get them where they need to be. So as a parent, as a grandparent, as an educator, we give students bells and whistles, and if that's what innovation is called, we give them that. We don't wait until we get you where you need to be before we give you those special things that students are passionate about and love. So with Edgecombe, even if our students are struggling academically, we can do both, right? We can walk and chew gum at the same time. We don't have to wait to give them what they want before we give them what they need. We can do both at the same time. And so I just don't want us to say, well, we need to wait. These kids don't know this, that, or the other. We need to give them both, because that's what they deserve. And if they see other children having innovative things happen at school, but they have to wait until I get to this certain level before I can experience it, it becomes internal. That becomes, I wasn't good enough, right? So we don't want to do that. So again, If the demerger happens, we are going to do it the Edgecombe way, which means innovation, with love, with dedication.
Right.
The parent who spoke earlier about having some struggles with the child tutoring, that's what school systems are for. That's what schools are for. That's what teachers are for. Yeah. And so if we see that happen, what we do as a team, and I'll ask Aaron and I'll ask Dr. Mark to stand up. I want you to stand up, because when you think about the work that happens in Edgecombe, it's not just me, it's not just Mr. Cannon. This is also the team that's at the table to say, how do we make this happen? We don't have all the answers, but together we figure it out, right? When we look at our data, it's moving in the right direction. We're not going to give up on our kids, demerger, not demerger. If they're our kids, we're going to do what has to happen to make them successful. Routine. That's what we do. So thank you. You will say goodnight. You're welcome to stay as long as you want to, but we're going to say goodnight because we have to work.